In this EC Master tutorial video, we will demonstrate how to set up and run the acontis EtherCAT Master software in Linux on an ARM-based STM32 microprocessor. We are using the STM32 MP135F-DK Discovery Kit from STMicroelectronics, and we'll first show you how to install and run Linux on this board, and then how to import the EC Master example application and get it running. The steps for preparing the host Linux development workstation, populating the STM32 target, and connecting to the STM32 board can be found in the STM32 MPU Ecosystem User Guide on ST's website. We will demonstrate those steps here and provide a link to the ST User Guide in the description. To get started, we already have our Linux development workstation that we will use as our main computer for preparing everything to be loaded onto the STM32 board. Open a terminal window on the Linux development workstation and execute the commands to create workspace directories for the STM32 tools and the STM32 Cube Programmer software. You will also need to download the STM32 Cube Programmer software from ST's website. The link for that is also in the description. Click through the installation windows, making sure to specify the directory locations we prepared earlier. Once the STM32 Cube Programmer software is installed successfully, there are just a few remaining commands to allow the software to access the USB ports of the host system in order to connect to the board from the host. Next, we will need to create a directory on the host system for the STM32 MP1 OpenST Linux Starter Package software. Download this from the ST website and extract the software into the newly created directory. This Starter Package software includes the binaries for the OpenST Linux distribution, firmware examples, and the OpenST Linux board support package. Be sure to set the DIP switches on the board to the correct positions for boot from USB. Now we can start the STM32 Cube Programmer software to flash the SD card on the STM32 board via USB. Follow through the steps to connect to the board and flash the appropriate binaries from the starter package. After the download completes successfully, make sure to change the DIP switches on the board back to the position for boot from SD card. Now you can power on and reset the board to boot into Linux on the STM32. The ST starter package does not include the acontis EC Master software, so you will also need to transfer the EC Master evaluation package to the file system on the STM32. You can do this in a variety of ways depending upon your setup. We will use FTP via the WinSCP application because on our setup, the EC Master evaluation package is hosted on another machine running Windows. Once everything is transferred over to the STM32 board, you can finally connect to the Linux distribution running on the STM32 via SSH. Log in as root, and you can now run the EC Master example application via the included optimized Ethernet controller driver for the DW3504. Thanks for watching, and hopefully this tutorial video helps you get started with EtherCAT on an ARM-based STM32 microprocessor. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below, or you can contact us on our website.